In this lecture, we'll continue the basic operations on signals. In my last lecture, we studied about operations performed on dependent variable, that is amplitude. In this lecture, we'll study operations performed on independent variable, that is time. There are three operations that can be performed on independent variable, that is time scaling, time shifting, time folding, or it is also known as reflection. Let's take one by one. Let's consider the first operation, that is time scaling. Consider x of t be a continuous time signal, then the signal y of t is obtained by scaling the independent variable time t by a factor a is given by y of t is equal to x of a into t. Here a is known as scaling factor and x of t is a continuous time signal. So the scaling factor a is multiplied with t. X of a t gives the output signal y of t. So here y of t is scaled version of x of t. If a is greater than 1, the signal y of t is compressed version of x of t. Similarly, if the value of a lies between 0 and 1, that is greater than 0 but less than 1, the signal y of t is expanded version of x of t. Let's take one example on this. Let this be a continuous time signal x of t. Now let y of t is equal to x of 2t. So here a value is 2, this is a value which is 2, and we know that a is greater than 0. That is, if a value is greater than 0, then y of t will be the compressed version of x of t, and the y of t is compressed by factor 2. I'll draw y of t here. So in this case, the y of t looks like this. Suppose this is y of t, say this is 0, 1 by 2, 1, 2, say this is minus 1 by 2, this is 1. So here y of t is equal to x of 2t. So here each time period is divided by 2. That is, the signal which exists at minus 1 will appear at minus 1 by 2, that is minus 1 divided by 2 is minus 1 by 2, and 1 divided by 2 is 1 by 2. So now the amplitude of the signal is 1, which will be same. That is, so this is y of t, which is compressed version of x of t. Y of 2 is equal to x of 1 by 2 t. So in this case, the value of a is less than 1. So if the value of a is less than 1, then we will get the expanded version of x of t. That is, so let this be y of t. This is 0, 1, 2. This is minus 1, minus 2. So now here each time period is divided by 1 by 2. That is, minus 1 divided by 1 by 2 is minus 2. So the signal which appears at minus 1 will now appear in at minus 2. Similarly, the signal which appears at 1, that is this point, will appear at 2. The amplitude of the signal is 1, which is as it is. So now I'll join these two points and I'll join these two points. So here we can observe this signal is expanded version of x of t. And similarly, in discrete time signals, if x of n is a discrete time signal, then y of n is equal to x of n into k for k greater than 0. So here y of n is defined only for integer values of k. If k value is greater than 1, then few values of discrete time signal y of n will be lost. We'll take one example. Say it is 8. So let this be x of n signal. Y of n is equal to x of 2n. Now let's draw y of n signal. So now consider n equal to 0. If we consider n equal to 0, then x of 2 into 0 is x of 0. That is, y of 0 is equal to x of 0. That is, if we take n equal to 0, then y of 0 is equal to x of 0. Therefore, the value of x of 0 is 1. Therefore, the y of 0 is 1 here. Now, similarly, if n is equal to 1, then y of 1 is equal to x of, that is 2 into 1 is 2, that is x of 2 is, magnitude of x of 2 is 3. Therefore, at n equal to 1, the amplitude of y of n is 3. Now, similarly, for n equal to 2, we have y of 2 is equal to x of 2 into 2, that is 4. So, x of 4 value is 5. Therefore, at n equal to 2, the amplitude of y of n is 5. Similarly, at n equal to 3, y of 3 is equal to x of 6. So, this is x of 6. At n equal to 6, the magnitude is 7. Therefore, y of 3 is magnitude is 7 here. So, here we can observe that y of n is scaled version of x of n, but during scaling we will lose some samples or some values. That is, at n equal to 1, the value of the signal is 2, which is lost, which is not appear here. Similarly, n equal to 3, the value of 4 is lost, and n equal to 5, that is value 6, is lost. Therefore, in discrete time signal, if k value is greater than 1, then some values of the discrete time signal y of n will be lost. Let's take second operation, that is time shifting. Let x of t denote a continuous time signal, then time shifted version of x of t will represent it as y of t is equal to x of t minus t naught, where t naught is time shift. If t naught value is greater than 0, the signal y of t is obtained by shifting x of t towards right. If t naught value is less than 0, the signal y of t is obtained by shifting x of t towards left. Here y of t is shifted version of x of t. That is, x of t is shifted towards right or towards left. Let's take one example. Let this be x of t signal. So let y of t is equal to x of t minus 2. So here we can observe that the value of t naught is equal to 2, that is, t naught is greater than 1. If the value of t naught is greater than 1, then the signal x of t is will shift towards right. We'll try to draw y of t now. So let this be y of t. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Here we have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So here x of t minus 2 is same as x of t, but shifted by 2 units.
shifted by 2 units means about 0 axis. That is the point which is at 0, this point will shift to point 2, and minus 1, this will be shifted to, that is minus 1 plus 2. That is, it will be shifted to minus 1 point will shift to 1, and it is 1 here, which is 1 plus 2, that is this point will be shifted to 3. That is, so the point 0 will shift at 2. This is the 0th point, center point, and the value of minus 1, that is minus 1 plus 2, that is 1, this will be shifted to 1 here. So here it is, minus 1 value will shifted here, and the 1 plus 2, that is 3, this point will be shifted to 3. That is, this point will be shifted to 3. Therefore, the same signal x of t exists between 1 and 3 with the same amplitude, that is, say it is amplitude is 1, so here also the amplitude is 1. Therefore, here y of t is equal to x of t minus 2, that is same as x of t shifted by 2 units towards right. Now we'll take another example. Let y of t is equal to x of t plus 3. So in this case, I can write it as y of t is equal to x of t minus of minus 3. So in this case, the value of t naught is minus 3. That is, if t naught value is less than 0, then the signal x of t will shift towards left. Here y of t is equal to x of t plus 3 is same as x of t, but shifted by 3 units towards left. We'll try to draw y of t now. So this is 0. Say this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Say it is minus 5. Let this be amplitude is 1. So now the signal which is at t equal to 1, that is 1 minus 3, that is minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2. The same signal which exists at t equal to 1 will shift at t equal to minus 2, 0. So here 0 minus 3, the 0 point will shift it to minus 3, and minus 1 minus 3 is minus 4, this point will shift to minus 4. Therefore, the same signal will appear in between minus 4 and minus 2. I'll draw here. So it is minus 4, minus 2. The amplitude is same. This is x of t plus 3. So here y of t is, this is same as x of t, but shifted towards left by 3 units. Similarly, in discrete time signals, if x of n is a discrete time signal, then y of n is represented as y of n is equal to x of n minus m. Here m is positive or negative integer. If m value is greater than 0, then y of n is obtained by shifting x of n towards right. If m value is less than 0, then y of n is shifted version of x of n towards left. Let's take one example. Let this be x of n. Let y of n is equal to x of n minus 3. So here we can observe that the value of m is equal to 3, which is greater than 0. Therefore, y of n is shifted towards right by 3 units. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Therefore, here y of n is x of n minus 3. So here the y of n begins from 3, 4, 5, and 6 and 7. That is 0 point will be shifted to 3, 1 will shifted to 4, 2 is shifted to 5, 3 is shifted to 6, 4 is shifted to 7. So this is y of n. That is y of n shifted towards right. Similarly, if y of n is equal to x of n plus 2. So this is nothing but y of n is equal to x of n minus of minus 2. Therefore, here m is equal to minus 2, which is less than 0. It means the y of n is same as x of n shifted towards left by 2 unit. Here I'll try to draw y of n value. Say this is minus 2. So the signal begins from minus 2. That is minus 2, minus 1, so here y of n appears between minus 2 to plus 2, which is same as x of n but shifted towards left by 2 unit. Now consider the third operation, that is time folding, or also known as reflection. If x of t is a continuous time signal, then reflected version of x of t is obtained by replacing t by minus t about t equal to 0. That is, y of t is equal to x of minus t. That is, t is replaced by minus t. So here y of t is reflected version of x of t. An event signal is the same as its reflected version, because we know that a signal is said to be event signal if x of t is equal to x of minus t. So x of t and x of minus t both are same. Therefore, an event signal is always same as its reflected version. Similarly, an odd signal is the negative of its reflected version, because we know that a signal is said to be odd signal if x of t is equal to minus of x of minus t. Therefore, odd signal is negative of its reflected version. We'll take one example.
Let this be a continuous time signal x of t, which exists between 0 to 2. Let y of t is equal to x of minus t. Therefore, here y of t is reflected version of x of t. That is, this is 0, say 1, 2, this is minus 1, minus 2. Here each t is replaced by minus t. That is, 0 point will be same as it is. 1 will appear at minus 1, 2, that signal will appear at minus 2. Therefore, we can represent y of t as like this. So amplitude remains same. So this is y of t, which is mirror image of x of t, or reflected version of x of t. Similarly, in discrete time signals, if x of n is a discrete time signal, then y of n can be represented as y of n is equal to x of minus n. That is, y of n is reflected version of x of n. We'll take one example. Suppose this is x of n signal. Say y of n is equal to x of minus n, can be represented as, so 0 point will be at 0 only. The signal at 1 will appear at minus 1. The signal which appears at 2 will appear at minus 2. The signal which appeared at 3 will appear at minus 3. Similarly, the signal at 4 will appear at minus 4. So this is reflected version of x of n, that is y of n. Thank you for watching.